Bonjour, Mela, since I haven't spoken to you in quite some time, and I've missed doing these short videos, today I'm going to talk to you while I'm putting on my daily makeup, so at least you get to see something that I do. Well, this is my skin without makeup, with all my flaws. I still have this bit of pigmentation here and here, but the rest is completely gone, so now today you got to see me. Naturally. So first I'm going to apply. I don't sell Inglot, but I love using it. Makeup I don't really sell a lot. So this is the under makeup base. So your foundation doesn't crack during the day. And it also smoothens down a bit the open pores. Then I have this brush which I love. This practically is used for anything you want to put on your face, like concealer, foundation, powder. Obviously, you have to keep it clean, because once the makeup gets stuck in it, you need to wash it. I use the orange one, slightly orangey, not the usual beige. Maybe you see it more. You see the difference, because when you see it on your own, you don't get to really see the difference. The orange one helps for dark skins, like mine, to cover freckles, pigmentation, old pimples that are brown. So basically the orange covers the brown. Those who have a fair skin tend to need more the green, which is more for red spots and redness, even people who have rosacea or fresh acne spots that are red, in that case you do the green on the spots that you need, not the orange like me. I also like using an applicator like this, or an old finished concealer that I have, to target particular spots that need a bit more coverage. That's fine. Here I have a fresh one coming up, and also on some lines. In the red around the nostrils, there's always a bit of that's it. Not bad. I used to have to cover half my face in this before because of the pigmentation. Now it's restricted to that, those tiny patches left, the stubborn patches. Covered a bit the sleepiness of the morning. If you do proper concealer, you barely need any foundation then, because I don't really like putting on foundation on my skin. It tends to get oily and sticky. Because I still have oily skin, even though I'm old. Okay. So for me, for every day, that's enough for coverage. Then I use a normal powder. I'm not even putting foundation. In fact, I have it ready here, but I think it was good enough as it is, and I'm not doing. And I have a lot to do today, because I have a lot of Mother's Day deliveries and packages to prepare for your special persons. And this year, it's really nice, because I've had a lot of packages ordered not directly from, for example, children to mother or husbands to wives, but even from friends to friends. Us women, we are amazing. I had loads of those friends thinking about their friends and giving them a Mother's Day treat. You don't really need to do much. Just even a 20 euro box of ampoules makes everybody happy. So this is just a lighter powder that I like doing to give some brightness to my face. of blusher. I change brush for the blusher because it's slightly red. I go for the big one. I hope this is not taking too long and I'm not boring you, but I wanted to stay a bit in touch with you. Just a bit of shimmer on the eyelids. Maybe slightly darker. I always get a bit of watery eyes while doing makeup. I don't know why. I'm a bit rough, I guess. Now I'll just put a darker shade of brown with some shimmer. Just to put some color on the edges. Lift your eyes slightly and makes you look like you made a bit of effort. In the morning, so I don't go around looking like the reality, like I've worked for like 60 hours this week or more if you count the online time answering to messages. But that's part of the fun. I certainly am not complaining. Soft gray. Blend in the edges. The trick about makeup is to have proper nice makeup, at least in my opinion, because I'm a bit of a naturalist. Not to see where it starts and where it ends. So if you put foundation, it shouldn't show. If you put blending on the eyeshadow, it shouldn't show where one color is starting and one color is ending. At least that is my favorite makeup. Especially for the day, for work, and then special occasions, maybe you can do some more sharp edges, like the eyeshadow, but for the day, I think it's the best thing to do. I like to fill in a bit my eyebrows because they're not even. Not just in shape, but my eye shape. One is curved and one is straight. And I have some empty spots also from extra plucking from when I was stupid. You just help them out a bit. Always natural, not too much. That's it. I have watery eyes, so I'm not going to put liquid liner. I don't think it's a very good idea. So I'm going straight for the mascara. And the mascara, I use the Ecrinal, the fortifying mascara. Not a normal mascara, since I have to apply it every day. Then when I go out, if I want an extra layer, I apply the other mascara on top of it. But touching my lashes, I never want a normal mascara. I always want the treatment. It comes in a transparent gel or in black. So at least touching my lashes, there's nutrients, not makeup only. And it still gives you a nice lift. I'm not one that wants super heavy lashes. I just want some definition. Then if you want to apply heavy lashes, it still makes them quite nice. I always manage to hit something if I'm rushing. Just a tiny bit like this. Not much. Lipstick I'm not doing because I'm wearing the mask and it goes all over my face. So that's it for today. I'm done. Quickie, not a lot of work, just enough to look a bit glowing. So let's go, getting ready for a busy day. Most of you, I'll be seeing you later. Bye.